Liberté, 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 liberté.
Liberté, 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 li I'm gonna What we need is a cut in the stream of becomings and appearances. For example, an event, a lact, act préalable.
I think it's possible and necessary at this time to as there are maybe a few members in the audience that does not really remember the story of the first five episodes of And as this would be the most essential to fully understand the complexity of the narrative and the networks of Intellectual, I will now give you a brief synopsis for all the people in the theory room. Episode 1 starts in the void, in a position of radical emptiness. The situation is all sleep and exhaustion, but after what seems to be many years, some abstract force is awakened and is incarnated into a form of being uttering the word which is the mathematical notation for the empty set. In episode 2, we encounter this creature reminiscent of the Norse Ymen, also Erda, after what seems to be a considerable amount of time. It has become springtime, but the creature deems it necessary to clear the world of all old nature and second nature to restructure the coordinates of its being in the world. In this new geography of tabula rasa, the being begins practicing breathing exercises to fight the constant condition of tiredness and müdigkeit. In this forced form of concentration and gathering of energy, music is invented.
Further music in particular. This is a romantic attitude. Click. They believe in immediate
click.
Action.
The sound is a little click low on this video. Episode 3 includes the aria I Want to Sleep. It's quite famous.
Ich will schlafen.
Which gradually leads into the magic transformation scene where the force of the mud which gains metaphorical qualities gradually. It somehow gets built a kind of tower of truth, out of which again leads to the famous birth scene. Three new characters are born, and in episode 4, we follow their path towards the invention of language, the erkenntnis of the we, and of notion of existence. It is a world of happiness and wholeness confined in this very congested space with no sense of an outside. They begin formulating aesthetic hypotheses on, for example, quantity and quality. One of the characters seem to inhabit a form of hubris or revolutionary geist and discovers by the force of his wisdom a kind of a surprising secret extending to the mudroom. It is a say here it's coming through the it's never nobody knew it was a different room in there. It is a blue tunnel, kind of an umbilical cord, and this further leads into a kind of a white cube, which in episode 5 will be transformed into an alchemical laboratory for the invention of new art and new political strategies for the world. When we reach episode 6, the social structure and intellectual development has reached a new level. The theories of French utopian socialist Charles Fourier is energetically discussed. Fourier's theories of freedom of the society part action between the organizing of social justice with the flow of passions, attractions, and enjoyment finds resonance with the three who forms a kind of brotherhood or commune to live in the spirit of Fourier. The notion of universal harmony is a central topic in Fourier's work, as is the idea of the orgy, or more specifically, the harmonic orgy, where artistic, sexual, and gastronomic pleasures are enjoyed to the full as a training and because I'm a little behind now. The character needs to be
what we need. Is a cut in the stream
dream of becomings and appearances. This yellow character proposes a more antagonistic strategy towards the soon-to-be future of pure communism for the whole of humankind. It's the main conflict of episode 6, which eventually leads to Yellowhead's growing fantasies. I don't have time. Because it's something with this kind of medium itself, which is problematic in this piece. Yeah, that's exactly the case. It's not sort of a piece in the normal sense. It's because, for example, the piece for Contrechamps, it's absolutely not part of this opera series at all. It's just an independent piece, and it's little to do with that. In Norway, in composition studies, we don't have these counterpoint studies. So it's just on top of it, so it's just gleichzeitig. And the whole this thing is an ongoing form of life, more than a piece in the traditional sense. So it's not so easy to present, yeah, in a festival concert setting. But anyway, you can see it on YouTube. And if you have not seen the first episode, it's a video on you in the media opera archive in the wardrobe upstairs. Yeah. Okay, but yeah, because in 2009 I founded my own opera house in my own living room. The name of the institution was the Norwegian Opera. Now this is the picture of the old opera house, and it's in these two windows that the scene was. I was myself, the opera director, composer, director, scenographer, ticket master, head of the workers' union, restaurant chief, web designer, Hayden Turner. The aim was to transcend the pragmatic, bureaucratic, networking, Facebooking, neo-lobotailed, or automation, liberalist world of the festival commission, the musician, and the Facebook internet, and to reclaim the power over the means of artistic production. The aim was to construct a utopian space for the ultimate artistic freedom. Yeah. In March 2015, the Norwegian Opera entered the next level to be even more disconnected with the system. A villa was bought on the countryside in the eastern part of Gross-Norwegen, whereas in the, yeah. This is the picture of the new opera house. This is the picture of the new opera house. Now that was the picture. That is the picture. And this is the idea for the logo. It started on the house. So only through total and I said this already, maybe. Total and radical, just from the system, it's possible, to freedom. Yeah. New opera house gives unique smashing the floor. Oh, this is scene 2 and scene 3 here. So beginning in the dark cellar of this opera house, a potentially infinite series of opera scholar that we produce in the beginning form. So Yeah, this is the solo here. So we closed on that. I think that was the end here. Yeah. going to... it's not maybe not so easy to understand this scene, because this apparatus, it's kind of a metaphor for Facebook, internet, mobile phone.
Break one home.
sperrt dir den Weg.
Es muss sein! Es muss sein!
Ei! Ei, 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 ei.
Of fire. erlangen Gesamtkunstwerk, which will be prepared in the bushes around Erich Kästner Turnhalle. The process will be streamed live from the camera attached to the yellow head's head to one of the monitors upstairs in the Norwegian Opera Archive in one of the wardrobes, and the resulting 1 second work will, in approximately 2 hours, be live projected onto the big screen in the main hall as part of the panel discussion.